Welcome back to my channel, friends. This is your Govindraj. In this video, I will give you an update on medical bonus and maternity benefit provided under labor legislations. First of all, adds up to all the working women. This is my little support to educate all the working women on the maternity benefit and medical bonus. If you are an employer or an officer or a manager who is responsible for compliance of law, this video will give you a more sense of law and you should be able to comply the provisions in a better and effective manner. Let's proceed, friends. It is required to know who is eligible for maternity benefit before we proceed further. Every woman employee who is under the ESI scheme, if she is not under ESI scheme, if she is working for a factory, mine or plantation or any shop or establishment in which 10 or more persons are employed, is covered. However, it is subject to fulfillment of certain eligibility conditions. Some of the state governments have made the applicability of Maternity Benefit Act to all shops and commercial establishments irrespective of the number of employees. There is another question which comes to mind, friends. How about employees who are hired through contractors? Answer to this question is Section 2O of the Maternity Benefit Act 1961 does not make any difference between the contract employees and permanent employees. The Section 2O covers also the contractual employees and it does not also make any difference between government establishments and private establishments. Therefore, all the contractual employees are also eligible for maternity benefit. Currently, there are two legislations which covers maternity and related benefits considering certain coverage conditions. These are Employee State Insurance Act 1948 and the Maternity Benefit Act 1961. Let's understand who is covered under ESI scheme. To get covered under ESI scheme, there are few things which are important. First of all, the area should be notified and the provisions of ESI are applicable to all employees employed in non-seasonal factories and every shop or establishment including hotels, restaurants, cinemas, motor transport undertakings, newspaper establishments, establishments engaged in insurance business, non-banking financial companies, port trust, airport authorities and warehousing establishment employing 10 or more persons. In some states and union territories, it is extended to private medical institutions, educational institutions employing 10 or more persons also. The current wage ceiling for applicability of ESI scheme is ₹21,000 per month. Any employee who has crossed this wage ceiling, she does not come under the ESI scheme maternity benefit. If woman employee is covered under ESI scheme, she is entitled to receive standard daily rate of wages for a period of 26 weeks, of which not more than 8 weeks shall precede the expected date of confinement or delivery. The standard daily rate is fixed by the ESIC corporation considering the contributions made to the fund. However, to become eligible for the standard daily rate of 26 weeks, a woman employee should have contributed 70 days in the preceding two contribution periods. The contribution periods are 1st April to 30th September and 1st October to 31st March. In the event the woman employee dies during delivery or after the delivery and the child survives, in this case, the benefit is payable for the entire 26 weeks or the pending part. If the child also dies, then the maternity benefit is payable up to the date of death of the child. The insured woman, if she is a commissioning mother or adopting mother, she is also eligible for 12 weeks benefit from the date child is handed over to her. The commissioning mother is nothing but is the one who wishes to have a child and prefers to get embryo implanted in any woman. Thus, the mother who gets the child from the surrogated mother is also eligible for maternity benefit of 12 weeks. In the case of adopting mother, the adoption should be legal and the child should be below the 3 months age. Suppose if an insured woman has two or more than two surviving children, then the maternity benefit gets restricted to 12 weeks, of which not more than 6 weeks shall precede the expected date of confinement. The maternity benefit is also available in the case of miscarriage or medical termination of pregnancy. In this case, the insured woman is eligible for 6 weeks maternity benefit immediately following the date of her miscarriage or medical termination of pregnancy. In the case of sickness arising out of pregnancy, confinement, premature birth of the child or miscarriage or medical termination of pregnancy, the insured woman is further eligible for an additional period of 1 month. The medical termination of pregnancy should not be unlawful termination. If the delivery takes place in a place where ESI has no medical facilities, the insured woman is also eligible for a medical bonus for 2 deliveries. The medical bonus currently under the ESI is rupees 5000. Let us also briefly know how a woman employee under ESI scheme can claim the maternity benefit. She can give a notice of her pregnancy to the ESI along with a certificate of pregnancy before the delivery. If she wishes to claim the maternity benefit before delivery, she should file the certificate on expected confinement and a claim application. However, this certificate of confinement to be filed within 30 days from the date of delivery. And she can also choose to claim the benefit after the confinement and submit an application along with certificate of confinement. In the case of miscarriage, this claim should be preferred within 30 days from the date of miscarriage along with certificate of miscarriage. There are few more documentation requirements from the ESI. It is suggested to the women employees to be in touch with the ESI local office or their concerned dispensaries. Now we will discuss the provisions under maternity benefit under Maternity Benefit Act 1961. The provisions and benefit are similar to the ESI provisions. However, let's see if there are some differences. A woman employee who is covered under the Maternity Benefit Act is entitled to receive her average daily wages or minimum rate of wages, whichever is higher, for a period of 26 weeks, of which not more than 8 weeks shall precede the expected date of confinement or delivery. However, there is an eligibility condition under this Act. She should have actually worked for 80 days in the 12 months immediately preceding the date of her expected delivery to become eligible. In case of woman employee dies during delivery, after the delivery, the provisions is similar to ESI provision, and the ESI provision in case of commissioning mother or adopting mother is also similar in comparison with Maternity Benefit Act 1961. In this case, she is eligible for 12 weeks benefit from the date child is handed over to her. The adoption should be legal and the age of the child should be below 3 months as said already. Suppose if a woman employee has 2 or more than 2 surviving children, the maternity benefit is similar to the ESI provisions, which is 12 weeks, and the provision is also similar in case of miscarriage or medical termination of pregnancy, which is 6 weeks benefit immediately following the date of her miscarriage or medical termination of pregnancy. In the case of tubectomy operation, the woman employee is eligible for 2 weeks maternity benefit following the day of her tubectomy operation. In the case of ESI, enhanced sickness benefit is available up to 14 days in the case of the tubectomy from the date of operation or from the date of admission in the hospital. In case of sickness arising out of pregnancy, delivery, premature birth of the child or miscarriage or medical termination of pregnancy or tubectomy operation, the woman employee is further eligible for an additional period of 1 month. This is also similar to the ESI provisions. Woman employees who are covered under the Maternity Benefit Act 1961 are also eligible to receive the medical bonus if the employer has not provided prenatal confinement or postnatal care. The prenatal confinement or postnatal care is nothing but pre and post hospitalization in case of delivery of the child, and this needs to be provided free of charge by the employer. If he has not provided, then he is required to give the medical bonus. The current medical bonus under Maternity Benefit Act is rupees 3500. A woman employee is required to give notice of her maternity benefit claim before the delivery or after the delivery as soon as possible. However, not giving notice will not disentitle her from the benefit. It is also important to know certain rights of woman employees considering the maternity benefit provisions under Maternity Benefit Act and also under ESI provisions. If the nature of work allows her to work from home, the employer may allow her to do so after the completion of maternity benefit period for such period and on such conditions as both of them may mutually agree. However, this is not an obligatory condition on the employer. Both of them should mutually agree if it is possible. And woman employee is also eligible to two nursing breaks after return from the maternity benefit in addition to the regular break until the child attains the age of 15 months. Employer is also required to provide creche if he has employed more than 30 women workers in case of factory or 50 or more employees in other cases. And woman employee is also entitled to know the benefits under the Act. The employer is under legal obligation to inform in writing about all the benefits related to maternity benefit. As I said earlier, the law does not discriminate based on the nature of employment. All women employees who are covered under the Maternity Benefit Act or the ESI provisions are entitled to the maternity benefit irrespective of the type of employment, and even if they are hired through contractor, provided they fulfill the eligibility conditions. And the employer is not allowed to alter the service conditions while the woman employee is on maternity leave. And it is also unlawful to discharge or dismiss woman employee during the absence on maternity leave. And it is also unlawful to give notice of discharge or dismissal which expires during absence due to maternity leave. And employer cannot reduce or deduct the wages for providing nursing breaks or for relaxing in nature of work assigned. There is a legal bar on the employer. No employer knowingly employ a woman during the 6 weeks immediately following the day of her delivery, miscarriage or medical termination of pregnancy. There is a similar responsibility is also cast on the woman. Every woman employee may have this question: what if I am not eligible under ESI even though I am covered under ESI provisions? If she has not become eligible under ESI even though she is covered under ESI, she still get covered under Maternity Benefit Act 1961 as long as she fulfills the eligibility criteria under the Act. So therefore, she is not required to worry in this case. Let me tell you one thing, friends. Any right will also have a corresponding duty or responsibility to fulfill. In this case also, women employees have certain responsibilities or duties to fulfill. When she is on authorized maternity leave, she is expected to not to work. If she disregard this and work elsewhere, she shall forfeit the right to claim the maternity benefit. And she is also required to promptly notify her situation to the employer and supply all the proof or documents which employer needs to consider her request. So far, we have discussed about maternity benefit provisions for female employees. Is there any legislation which talks about paternity benefit for the working fathers? With respect to private establishment, there is no legislation which talks about paternity benefit. Therefore, the paternity benefit is not available under labor legislations. However, certain employers have voluntarily provided paternity benefit. We are in the era of labor reforms and codifications, friends. We should also know what are the changes proposed in the Social Security Code 2019. There are no significant changes proposed, friends. All provisions and benefits are largely retained in the code. Thank you for watching my video, friends. If you like it, don't forget to subscribe this channel. If you have any clarification or doubts, and if you would like to get in touch with me, my coordinates are provided here. You can always write to me or talk to me. Thank you again and see you soon, friends.